from Fellows of St John's Cambridge to Oxford. What is the Oxford History of England all about?
Yes, England.
You'd think it would be, with a title like that.
France.
Not France, neither.
All right, this one, Abyssinia. Yeah, come on. Yes.
They didn't predict that.
No. Thank you.
Oxford History of England. Mm. It's simply, when you say England sometimes, accidentally, you might actually mean...
Britain. England.
Britain. No. But you might say, when you meant Britain, you say, oh, yeah, you know, the English are very good at blah, blah, blah. You should be Britain or the, you know. And the fact is, it was perfectly normal to say England for all of Britain, right up until the 1930s, when Scottish nationalism arose and they got rather offended by it. Benjamin Disraeli signed the Treaty of Berlin as the Prime Minister of England, and it meant Great Britain, technically. The one part stood for the whole. So the Oxford History of England is actually the history of the British Isles. I'm not saying it was right, but it's just as it was. Mm. There you are. As A.J.P. Taylor, the great historian, noticed, when the Oxford History was launched a generation ago, he said, England was still an all-embracing word. It meant indiscriminately England, Wales, Great Britain, United Kingdom, even the British Empire. This is not to say the term British wasn't used, it's just that England could mean the whole thing. So, where does the word England come from? Why are we called English? What is England about? Yes.
Go on.
Well, one, you know, all right, the Angles.
Yes, quite correct.
You see?